योगी स्पिरिचुअल ब्रीदिंग द योगीज नॉट ओनली ब्रिंग अबाउट डिजायर्ड मेंटल क्वालिटीज एंड प्रॉपर्टीज बाय विल पावर कपल्ड विद रिदमिक ब्रीदिंग बट दे ऑल्सो डेवलप स्पिरिचुअल फैसिलिटीज और अदर एड इन द अनफोल्डमेंट इन द सेम वे द एंशियंट फिलोसफीज टीच दैट द मैन हैज मेनी फैकल्टीज विच आर एट प्रेजेंट इन अ डॉर्मेंट स्टेट बट विच विल बिकम अनफोल्डेड एज द रेस प्रोग्रेसेस They also teach that man, by the proper effort of the will, aided by favorable conditions, may aid in the unfoldment of these spiritual facilities, develop them much sooner than in the ordinary process of the evolution. There is, of course, no mystic property in the breath itself, which produces such wonderful results, but the rhythm produced by the yogi breath is such as to bring the whole system, including the brain, under perfect control and in perfect harmony. And by this means, the most perfect condition is obtained for the unfoldment of these latent faculties. The development of the two phases of spiritual consciousness are the consciousness of the identity of the soul and the consciousness of the connection of the soul with the universal life. Both of the exercises given below are simple and consist of mental images firmly held, accompanied with rhythmic breathing. The student must not expect too much at the start, but must make haste slowly and content to develop as does the flower from seed to blossom. Soul consciousness. The real self is not the body or even the mind of the man. These things are but a part of his personality, the lesser self. The real self is the ego, whose manifestation is an individuality. The real self is a drop from the divine ocean and is eternal and indestructible. It cannot die or be annihilated, and no matter what becomes of the body, the real self still exists. It is the soul. One may develop the faculties so that they will be in consciousness of the reality of the soul and its independence of the body. The yogi plan for such development is by meditation upon the real self or soul, accompanied by rhythmic breathing. The following exercise is the simplest form. Place your body in a relaxed, reclining position. Breathe rhythmically and meditate upon the real self, thinking of yourself as an entity independent of the body, although inhabiting it and being able to leave it at will. Think of yourself not as the body, but as a spirit, and your body as but a shell, useful and comfortable, but not a part of the real you. While meditating, ignore the body entirely, and you will find that you will often become almost entirely unconscious of it, and will seem to be out of the body, to which you may return when you are through with the exercise. This is the gist of the yogi meditative breathing methods, and if persisted in, will give one a wonderful sense of the reality of the soul and will make him seem almost independent of the body. The sense of immortality will often come with the increased consciousness, and the person will begin to show signs of spiritual development which will be noticeable to himself and others. But one must not allow himself to live too much in the upper regions or to despise his body, for he is there on this plane for a purpose and must neglect not his opportunity to gain the experiences necessary to round him out. The universal consciousness, the spirit in man, which is the highest manifestation of his soul, is a drop in the ocean of spirit, apparently separate and distinct, but yet really in touch with the ocean itself and with every drop. The yogis seek to attain this state of universal consciousness by meditation and rhythmic breathing, and many have thus attained the highest degree of spiritual attainment possible to man in this stage of his existence. The following exercise will be found to do much toward developing the universal consciousness in those who faithfully practice it. Place your body in a reclining, relaxed position, breathe rhythmically, and meditate upon your relationship with the universal mind, of which you are but an atom. Think of yourself as being in touch with all and at one mind with all. See all as one and your soul as a part of that one. Feel that you are receiving the vibrations from the great universal mind and are partaking of its power and strength and wisdom. The two following lines of meditation may be followed. 1. With each inhalation, think of yourself as drawing into yourself the strength and power of the universal mind. When exhaling, think of yourself as passing out to others that same power, at the same time being filled with love for every living thing and desiring that it be a partaker of the same blessings which you are now receiving. Let the universal power circulate through you. 2. Place your mind in a reverential state and meditate upon the grandeur of the universal mind and upon yourself too in flow of the divine wisdom, which will fill you with illuminating wisdom, and then let the same flow out from you to your brothers and sisters whom you love and would help. This exercise leaves with those who have practiced it a newfound sense of strength, power and wisdom, and a feeling of spiritual exhalation and bliss. It must be practiced only in a serious, reverential mood and must not be approached trivially or lightly. All the exercises covered in the science of breathing in the entire playlist are for the few who can understand, and for others it will not have any attraction. Do not indulge in these exercises too often, and do not allow the blissful state produced to render you dissatisfied with the affairs of everyday life, as the latter are useful and necessary for you, and you must never shirk a lesson, however disagreeable to you it may be. All is good and everything has its place. Many of the students who practice these exercises will in time wish to know more. Rest assured that when the time comes, we will see that you do not seek in vain. Go on in courage and confidence, keeping your face towards the east from whence comes the rising sun. Peace be on to you and on to all men. I hope you're enjoying the videos. I'm not going to beg or persist or force you to subscribe or like the channel. But if you feel the content is worth it, then reward it as such. Thank you so much, and have a great day.